Whoa, whoa, whoa. Be still as I see you move. What am I doing? I'm looking for fish. Whoa, there's a rainbow trout. Have you ever found a fish in the wild? Maybe even caught one yourself? If so, that's awesome. Fish are one of the most interesting and underappreciated animals in our state. Did you know that across the world, there are as many species of fish as there are reptiles, mammals, and amphibians, and birds combined? In North Carolina alone, we have almost 1,000 different species of these scaly swimmers. That's not to say they're easy to find. Fish can be both fast and skittish. Plus, they live in the water, where it's sometimes really hard for us to go. Now, if you've never found a fish in the wild before, don't even know what a fish is, don't worry. I'm Andrew, an educator from the North Carolina Arboretum, and I have some fish facts for you future ichthyologists. An ichthyologist is a scientist who studies fish. In North Carolina, you can find fish in both freshwater, saltwater, and a mixture of the two. That's called an estuary. Now, a freshwater mountain stream might hold a brook trout, our state freshwater fish, or a creek chub, small enough to live between the rocks and in the shallow waters. But if you go to a river, fish can get way larger in order to swim against the strong currents in deeper waters, like a smallmouth bass or a muskie. Stillwater lakes can be deep and dark, fit for a channel catfish, bluegill, or largemouth bass. In estuaries, there are many tight spaces from the plants that grow there. These sheltered environments are an ideal nursery for young ocean fish, such as our state saltwater fish, the red drum. And just off the shoreline, you might find fish best suited for the salty, nutrient-rich ocean, such as the sea mullet or bluefish.
With so many different types of fish and other things that live in the water, how do we know what a fish is and what a fish isn't? Well,
first of all, fish are aquatic. This means they live underwater. Now, some fish jump, glide, or even crawl onto the surface, but they still spend most of their lives underneath the water. Second is gills. These are one of the best ways to identify a fish. Gills are vertical slats on the side of a fish near the head. Fish breathe by first taking water in through their mouths and then passing it out through their gills, which gather oxygen out of that water. Number three is fins. Not all fish have appendages, arms and legs, like you and me, but if they do, they're usually flat and thin, like a fan. Number four is scales, like this. Now, not all fish have scales. Some, like sharks and eels, have skin instead. Good boy, good boy. Five is underneath the skin. Fish are vertebrates, like us mammals, reptiles, birds, and amphibians. This means they have a backbone, which supports their body and their nervous system. Finally, fish are cold-blooded, or more accurately, poikilothermic. This means their body temperature changes based on the temperature of their environment. Now, not everything with fish in the name is a fish. For instance, a crawfish? Not a fish. Why? Well, a crawfish does live underwater and does have gills, but it doesn't have scales, or fins, or even a backbone.
From our mountain creeks to Piedmont lakes and salty Atlantic coastline, North Carolina is an amazing place to find and study fish.
But why is it important to study fish? Well, fish are an essential part of many aquatic ecosystems. Their role as either predator or prey is key to the survival of many other types of organisms. Fish are also diverse, with amazing examples of how life evolves wildly unique adaptions to suit its environment. But fish are also vulnerable to threats like overfishing and changes in water quality. These are amazing creatures that are critical to the survival of all sorts of organisms, including us humans. By learning about fish, we can better protect them. And with so many amazing varieties living in the lakes, creeks, and coastal waters of North Carolina, it's worth our time to try and get to know them a little better. By becoming an eco-explorer, you can help scientists learn more about local species and also earn cool badges like this ichthyology badge, or prizes like this aquatic fishing net or fishing pole set. If you're not one already, you can become an eco-explorer on our website, ecoexplorer.net. Anyway, I've got to get back to working on my badge. I'm going to put together this fishing rod set. Oh, but by the way, good luck, have fun, and keep exploring.